happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? Craft Farms here, back with another video. So today was supposed to be an American Truck Sim video, but unfortunately my American Truck Sim does not want to open correctly. So I'm just going to do like a channel update thing here and talk about some stuff. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is FS15. So here in about, I think he said a month or two, we're going to be switching to a new map. And I'm going to show you that map right here. This map is called Four Seasons Farms. If you want to see the progress on this, go check out AB Modding on Facebook. It's a page. So here's some pictures of it. He said the map is just about done. This map looks just awesome. It's got kind of some different multi-fruits on it as well. Just a very, very nice looking map. So once it comes out, we'll be switching over to that, and basically we'll just be taking the equipment that we have and the money that we have and moving it all over to this farm. It must be based in Pennsylvania. Hillside potatoes, national beef, so it must have pigs and beef on it. Looks like soybeans there maybe. I know it's got like oats on it for sure. It's a pretty cool map. So if you want to go see more of the progress of it, check out the AB Modding Facebook page. Really nice page. Actually, a good friend of mine runs it, or owns it, I guess I should say. So here's a farmyard. Looks really, really nice. So yeah, I can see the beef or pig building there. Some beans, it looks like, maybe. Pretty neat textures on it, too. Just a great looking map overall. Got some tanks set up. A nice Case dealership. So yeah, that's that. Now, for the next thing I want to talk about. As you can see, I'm opening up my summer car. I just got this game on Thursday. And I'm on my second car because the first car, I accidentally messed some stuff up. I missed putting the half shafts into the car, which is like the third or fourth step. And I got all the way to putting the engine in, and it was too late then, so I just started over. And now I also, you know, have a better knowledge of how to play the game. And, so yeah. Now, I am gonna do video of this game. I'm gonna do a car, just kind of, you know, get it down to how to play and everything. And then, once I'm done with this car, then I'll start a, you know, series on it. Once I figured out, you know, how to do it and all. So now the part that I really need to talk about is, how do you guys want to see this? Do you want me to do this in replace of American Truck Sim? So doing this on Wednesdays and Sundays. There we go. On Wednesdays and Sundays, or should I put this in on, like, you know, one of the days, or how would you guys like to see this? So you let me know how you would like to see this. So yeah, let me know, because I'm really enjoying this game so far, and I have a feeling there's some people that also would like to, you know, see it. So if you would, you know, let me know, and let me know how you want me to do it. These dang bearings don't go on. So yeah, you let me know if you would like this in replace of American Truck Sim, or should I do this, you know, on one of the American Truck Sim days, or what you would like to see. Okay, I can't get this dang thing on. Main bearings, they go just like that. So why won't you go on? I know this is how it's gotta go, because I had the engine put together once already. Oh, I saw a check mark. There we go. There's one. So yeah, like I said, this is my second start to the car, because I had... One, I was dying a lot, because I didn't... Like, I was trying to find my way to town, and every single time, I would end up dying for some odd reason. Or not odd, but I'd end up dying for some reason. Usually it was because, like, the first time I died, it was I didn't, what size did that say? Oh, 9. Because I hit a tree. Okay, makes sense. Second time was because I died of hunger. Well, I had to go to the store to get food, so then had to try and find the van. Well, then I died of thirst, and then, yeah, it was just crazy. And then I was never clean. I couldn't figure out how to get the sauna to work, but I figured it out now. So yeah, just lots of odd issues, and you know, just little things that I just didn't think of and that kind of thing, but I've got it now, and I'm back on track to doing this correctly. So let's see here, this guy, oops, this one's going like this. Which piston is it? That one. So yeah, let me know what you want to see, if you want this in replace of American Truck Sim, or in addition to American Truck Sim. And then, yeah, I don't know, in the post for the Four Seasons Farms, it just said that he was hoping to have it out in a month or two. He's, you know, it's not a for sure, it'll be out, you know, in exactly 1 month. It's just kind of a, you know, here's my guess of when it'll be out. And, yeah, so, that's not gonna work. So, yeah, then once that does come out, then we'll just take whatever equipment we have, transfer it over to that map, and, take our money with, and then that'll be it. So, I guess, now, for the rest of the time for this video, we'll just kind of work on getting this put together. So yeah, this game is on Steam. It is $15. If you enjoy tinkering with cars and stuff, I would definitely say to get it, because it's a lot of fun. I like this game. It's, you know, enjoyable. You get to, you know, mess with this thing and... my phone is driving me crazy. What was I saying? But yeah, it's a lot of fun. You know, you get to put together this car, and then once it's all put together, then you can, you know, you can, from what I understand, you can, like, buy aftermarket parts. Okay, I need to silence this. from what I understand, you can buy aftermarket parts too, and then you can you can add all kinds of neat stuff to it. So really just a really fun looking game. And I was watching Jeff Faviano do this, and then I decided, well, I'm gonna go ahead and get it. And so I went ahead and got a Steam gift card, applied it to my account, and then bought this. And right away, it downloaded really fast. It's not a huge file size. It's only like, it's under 300 megabits. So it's, for a game, it's really, really small. And then, I just Googled my summer car, how to build car, and then I found this guide to it. So, you can have a guide, and it kind of helps you figure out how to put this thing together and whatnot. And it's a lot of fun. I mean, I don't have a lot of knowledge about this kind of stuff, so this is just kind of a fun little way of messing around with it. And it is like a foreign game, because it's in a different language, but it does have English subtitles, so that's good. Okay, so now I need to attach this to the hoist, correct? Yes, so then I need a 10 millimeter for that. Okay, we'll get that put away, and then we'll grab the hoist, get it brought over here to the engine. So now with this, it says just start tightening and it'll start going in place. So that's what I'm gonna do. There, it's in place. Okay, so now I'll just kind of back this thing up. Whoops, I just totally cleared off my shelf. Whoopsie daisy. Okay. So the car is white right now, and then we'll paint it afterwards, eventually, of course. Carburetor, 8mm. Carburetor is where? Okay, what am I doing? Getting carburetor. Ay. So yeah, the one thing that kind of annoys me about this game is how touchy it is to get a check mark. To get a check mark, you have to be in the most perfect spot. I mean, yeah, in real life you would have to be, spot on to get it in, but this thing, it's difficult to find that, which is kind of annoying. But so we need the rocker shaft that has 5 8mm. I have the 8mm. Some things are definitely easier than others to get put on here, but other things, it's like, oh my goodness. There we go, let's bring that back a little bit. And then over a little bit as well, because I don't want to have to be falling in the pit. So yeah, I'm not going to start this series right now. Maybe on Wednesday I'll be starting it. We'll see. It depends on whether or not I get this car finished by then. I'm not going to do aftermarket parts on this one. I just want to get the concept down. So I need, it's a 7mm. I just want to get, the main stuff down and figured out, and then, when I do an actual series on it, then I'll go ahead and, then I'll worry about aftermarket parts and all that. And then when I do the series, I'm gonna get it set up so that way I don't have to keep going to my desktop to view the guide, because I know that probably will get annoying to some people, which to me it kind of is annoying too, but you know, that's what I got so far. So we need the camshaft. This guy is a pain to get in. Huh. Easier this time around, that's for sure. But, yeah, so... okay, so now we need camshaft gear. Yes, and that just has 110mm. And the timing chain. Okay. Whoops, that's the wrong thing. Camshaft gear. That's what I need. See, it did take me a while to figure out how to play this. Because, like, it really doesn't give you that much instruction. You just kind of got to figure stuff out yourself. And, I just had to do a lot of Google searching, is what I did. To figure it out. Okay, so what did it say I needed next? The timing cover. But, yeah, this... it's a lot of fun. That's, you know... it's really all I can say about it. It's just, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, I mean, if you're a real-life mechanic, then, you know, some of this you might understand more than somebody like myself. You know, but even for, you know, like, if you are a mechanic, I think I've seen a couple people that play this that are mechanics, and, you know, they said it, even said it's still really enjoyable. It's, I don't know, you know, it's just, it's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. It's fun to be tinkering around with a car. You know, and you start from the bottom and you have to work your way all the way back, you know, all the way from the bottom to the top. Heck, I remember where this thing goes. I just saw a check mark. Yeah, so if you have 15 bucks and are looking for a new game to play on Steam, totally would recommend this. It's just, you know, other than the fact that it's, you know, in a different language and stuff like that, kind of, you know, weird in that aspect, it's still really fun. Okay, so yeah, I was all the way down here to the fan belt, and I had to go to the store and buy a fan belt, because for whatever reason, I guess I'm not the only one to have this issue, but, like, the fan belt, you had to go buy it, because you didn't start with it. Some people have started with it, other people haven't. Like myself, I searched everywhere for it, and then I ended up having to go and search online and find some stuff, and in order to find it or find out how to get it. But in the end I did figure it out. Okay, so it's got 1.7. Oops, I didn't mean to open Dropbox. It's got 1.7 and 1.10, and then the fan belt. And the 10 is down here. Okay, and there's the belt. Okay, so now you gotta get the screwdriver. You gotta get that on just right. Okay. So now for the next part. So then the engine plate, and then the starter, which needs a 7mm. Engine plate is right there. This guy goes on. Oh, I can put it on from here, I guess. Whatever. If it goes on, it goes on. Starter. This guy goes. There's definitely a lot of stuff to this little engine. Oh, right there. That's right. Is it just that one? No, it's got two. Oh, okay. So the other one's over there. Right in here somewhere. There it is. Okay, so now we need the flywheel. So yeah, today is actually Friday, and this is the last video I have to get recorded and whatnot for the week, so that's nice. So I need a 6mm. Then we get to put all this stuff together. And put it on here. That's one thing that drives me nuts is you get it and then you try and click and away it goes. And then you just end up dropping it. Okay, so that's on. We're getting close to done with the engine. So now the oil pan, which has 8 7mm. I think it's 4 on either side. There it is. Six. 7. Oops, I don't think that one's all the way up, is it? Nope. I needed, what, a 10? 13. The next is the gearbox. And that's this bolt under here that needs to be tightened. Okay, so the gearbox needs 7 and 10. That is this monstrous piece right here. And there it is. So there's all these guys here. And then one 10 millimeter way back there. That's that guy. Okay, then we need a 6, correct, for this next piece? For the drive gear, which, yes, needs a 6. And that is this little guy right here. A lot of little bolts on this piece. Hey, so then I'm actually just going to record until I finish this engine, so. Okay, so the spark plugs, and then the fuel pump. Fuel pump needs a 7. So get these spark plugs in here. No, come back here. Okay, so then the next piece was what? The fuel pump. So let's get the fuel pump put on here. Where is my fuel pump? Right here. Well, that's the distributor. Where'd the fuel pump go? I remember I had... Oh, it's this guy. This long, wavy, curly thing. I can't remember how this thing goes on, though. This was another piece that I had on. There we go. Okay, so then we'll get this guy tightened down, then we'll get the spark plug wrench. Tighten down the spark plugs. One, two, three, and four. Now, what size does the distributor need? That needs 1 6 millimeter. I'll go ahead and get this guy put in, and then that'll be the last piece right now till it's in the car. Now it's ready to go in the car. See, I'm gonna raise this up all the way right here. It is all the way up, okay.
Thank you.
Okay, now it's ready to go in. So I just need to figure out, okay, what size do I need? 11 millimeter. Let's get this thing put in here, and then that'll be all for the video. Gotta sit and drop it in. So it says bolts will appear once it's in place. We've got to come this way a little bit. That in place now. No, it's not. Where exactly is this guy that he's... Oh, I see. He's down over here. Whoa! I can see one reason why it's not in place. It's gotta go this way a little more. There we go. Now let me guess that was... No, that looks like it should be about right. So now let's see here. We have some bolts to tighten. Maybe over on this side? I'm not sure here. I do have this in the right way, I hope. Let's see, the starter should be in the front of the car. Yeah, that's the right way. Just gotta be touchy, huh? Okay, so that needs to be, like, right there. So it has to come back and over. Oops. Oh, I suppose it would help to have that away. Back and over. Like right in there somewhere. Okay, let's see if that did the trick. It's gotta come back and then down. So let's just drop this thing down here. See if that's far enough down for it. Ooh, I think I see bolts. I do, sweet. Sweet, sweet, sweet. So there's two, and then it says there's one back here somewhere. In the back of it. Ah, right there. So then I can take this and go get a 10, and we can remove the hoist, and then the engine is sitting in the car. Perfect. So now just raise this. What? Is it not all the way off? It mustn't be. Did I tighten the wrong, loosen the wrong thing? No. That's the right bolt. Maybe if I just take it out of here. There we go. Yep, that's what it needed. Okay, we'll get this thing put away. Or set, like, back over here in the corner somewhere or something. I think, right... there's good enough. Okay, so yeah, as I was saying, you know, let me know what you guys want to see. If you want to see this just replace American Truck Sim or what. But that's going to do it for this video. I got to go eat, drink, pee, and sleep, and take a bath, I guess, it looks like. So, thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at, as well as some stuff like my PC specs and my upload schedule are also listed down there. So be sure to check that all out, and be sure to check out all the other videos, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching.